buddy. You might not have noticed, but there are lots of English people living in Theragatha nowadays. In this program, we're going to meet some of them who've probably been here for a lot longer than you think. This morning,
Judith, hello.
Julian, good morning.
Nice to see you.
And you.
Oh.
And this is your house.
Yes,
lovely.
Yes.
Very nice.
It was a hostel years ago. And we had to completely refurbish it.
But look at this. It's original.
Right. I'm going to make you an English breakfast, Judith.
This is very nice.
The most complicated part
is
the baked beans.
Opening the can.
I have to open the can.
Where did you buy the baked beans, John?
In the supermarket.
In the supermarket.
In the pan. Put the heat on. And that's it. And wait. Now I'm going to do the scrambled egg.
I didn't expect to be having an English breakfast this morning.
Always have an English breakfast. Well, at least once a month, anyway.
A nice cup of tea.
With a nice cup of tea. Well, how to make scrambled eggs. First, you put a bit of butter in the pan. And melt the butter. And when the butter's been in the fridge. This takes some time.
Yeah. Didn't expect to see you cooking this morning, Julian.
Well, I cook. I do cook from time to time. The English breakfast actually is something that we sometimes have at the weekend.
Yeah.
But
not during the week.
There's no time during the week.
It's a great flat you've got here, Julian. When you first came to Spain, did you live in Zaragoza?
No, the first year we lived in Madrid, and we came to Zaragoza after a year, partly because Zaragoza is such a beautiful place to be, but partly because my wife Inez wanted to open her own business here, which was much easier in Zaragoza. How many eggs do you want, Judith?
Just one, please.
Well, I'm going to make three, okay, in total.
Okay.
Yeah, so she wanted to start her own business here, which was easier in Madrid. In Zaragoza, I mean, than in Madrid, which was sort of expensive and difficult. And here there was a lot of family support. I'm going to put a little bit of milk into the eggs. Not too much, just a splash. And a bit of pepper, and a bit of salt. And the secret is to keep stirring, which is what I'm not doing at the moment. Now I shall start stirring. And in about 2 minutes, it will be ready. And this was, you know, years ago. And I'm now going to go over here and put the toast, which I carefully prepared earlier, onto our plates. And this is made with unhealthy sliced white bread from a packet. Not the normal delicious bread you get here.
I noticed you've got a kettle here.
Yes. Well, when I first came here, it was impossible to find a kettle in Spain. And the time, would you like your scrambled egg on the toast or by the toast?
On the toast,
on the
please.
Okay. I thought this would be a very good business for somebody, not me, importing kettles. And selling them, but somebody must have thought of it, because now you can get kettles here, you know, in the Court Anglaise and so on. But they're very useful, not just for making tea and coffee, but any water you need to boil for anything, you can use a kettle. Right, the ham, this is extremely complex operation, because I have to open the packet and I have washed my hands, but I will use a knife to get the ham.
My mum always says that to me.
As well. One piece will be enough.
That's fine.
Right. And here we are. Breakfast has been made already. I'm now going to pass you your breakfast. Would you like some mustard? I have some English mustard.
No, that's fine.
No?
Fine, thank you.
Okay. I shall just bring some salt and pepper in case we want some.
And a nice drink of tea.
Which
has to be accompanied by a nice cup of tea.
Yes.
Solution to everything. A nice cup of tea.
Right. And here we are. London, because it's easier.
Of your life.
there for 10 years before I came to Spain. And so I think that's long enough to sort of pretend it's my city. I mean, everybody here has a pueblo, you know?
Yeah.
And I really don't, because of having lived in so many different places.
Yeah.
So there's nowhere that exactly feels like home.
No.
Possibly here. I've lived in Zaragoza longer than I have lived. So this is our home, isn't it?
It is, yeah. So do you think that could ever really be so? Do you think you could feel as though you're more from here than there because you've been here longer?
I don't know. When I visit my family in England, I feel like I'm going home.
Yeah.
But on the plane back, I feel also that I'm arriving home. So it's like there are two homes. Whether that sort of changes in the end, I really
sometimes it's a kind of relief to get back here.
Yes.
Because here is every day, it's routine.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yes. Yeah. So I've lived here now for 25 years.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. Not one of those who care. He's a little.
So, actually, Julian, it's strange that an English person in Zaragoza chooses to live right in the city centre, probably the oldest part of Zaragoza.
Yes.
What do you like about it? You must like
Well, I do like it, yes. It's very convenient. I mean, I can go almost anywhere. Mm-hmm. I have to go 10 minutes walking.
Yeah.
And also it has the advantage that living right in the centre, in the Calle Alfonso,
yeah,
I can see all the Easter processions, of which there are about 30 during Easter week.
So we know to go next time we want to see the procession.
That's right. I'm thinking of renting the balcony for you for a very fair price.
Okay.
During the Fiesta of Pilar, it is extremely difficult to walk down the street here. But on the other hand, one gets the whole atmosphere of what, people in Zaragoza like.
And when you came here at first, was this the first place you lived?
Yes, we've always lived in this area. Yes, not in the same flat. As the family gets bigger, we've had to. Blast, come on. Sorry. But we've always lived in the centre, yes.
Right.
And I'm so used to it, I think I would find it a bit strange going to live
on
the outside. Not at the moment.
Yeah.
Not at the moment. The other advantage is that for teaching, it's very easy for students to get to where I live, and I do quite a lot of work at home.
Yeah. What do you do on a normal morning around here?
The first thing I do is take the dog for a walk. Luckily, we can go down by the river, so it's very convenient and very nice. And I go to buy the bread and this sort of thing, make sure the children get to school, and then I start work at 8 or 9 in the morning.
Fantastic.
Early start. Right.
Don't have much money, but if I did, I'd buy a big house where.
Going to buy the bread, which is an extremely exciting thing to do, which I do every morning.
Okay.
And I'm going to do it here, which is my sister-in-law's bread shop.
Very nice.
And the bread is very nice. I can't go in with glass. Do you mind holding him? I go in and buy the bread.
Yeah.
Okay? I shall go and get the bread.
Okay, I'll wait for you.
Okay. Hello. Bien, muy bien, gracias. Pues sí, como siempre.
¿Todo bien?
Vale, todo bien, gracias. ¿Tú? Pues toma, gracias. Bueno. Ah, Marianne. Very well. Thank you. And you? Very well. I'm here buying the bread as usual, and we are making a program in English. So with us, the dog, but Yes, indeed. And there are some wonderful buildings here, I have to say. To start with, over there is the famous Sail, La Sail, which not everybody knows is the cathedral here, unlike the Pilar, which is in fact Basilica rather than a cathedral. And also here, La Lonja, which is my favourite building in the square.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 16th century Renaissance building. Very beautiful. It used to be a market. Agricultural corn market.
Yeah.
Now they hold exhibitions there. And here is a statue to Goya. Goya was from Paragosta, from a village near here called Fuente Toro. And these statues represent some of the figures in some of his paintings. And here we have the City Hall, which is obviously far more recent, but built in keeping with the existing buildings. And over here on the right, we have the Pilar itself, but we can have a look at that. Why don't we go and have a look? I should think so.
Do you come here very often yourself, Julian?
Well, I do. I come every day with Blas, the dog, who needs to be walked quite frequently. Not many trees here for him. I try to go where there are trees. And when friends, family come here, I always show them the plath.
And everybody likes it, of course. This is just
Yes. Well, I think it's because it's so big, you know, and monumental that people are quite impressed by it. And of course, it's for the people from the UK, for example, it's very easy for them to get here now with the Ryanair.
That's certainly put us on the map.
Yes. Put London on the map as so many people go to London from here. I remember years ago when I first took, I think there were Iberia flights from Zaragoza, and there were always more crew than passengers. Completely changed now, which is excellent. Yes, I think so, yes. I have to confess, I'd never heard of it before I came to live here. But
and I think the square's changed a lot as well.
Well, this used to be, when I first came to live here, this was a large roundabout, there was traffic everywhere, and now it's so much better.
So much better.
So let's head down towards the other side of the square and see what there is to see.
Behind us, slightly anonymous looking building, were the law courts, which have now moved to the expo area, where the expo was.
Yes.
Right, why don't we go down to the river now to give the last a walk, and then we'll
the weather holds out for
down there, it'll probably be very sunny.
Much better. Okay.
And so then we'll go and see a nurse.
Right.
Okay. On the tram.
Yeah.
But I'm going to leave Blas at home because he's allowed on the tram. But I'm not very confident that he'll enjoy himself on the tram.
Okay. So we'll take him home on the way.
That's
okay,
fine.
Let's go then. Summer, does he have a swim
yet had to call out the emergency services. You have to be a bit careful. The current's quite strong. But no, he does like a swim. I sometimes use the tram, yes. Yeah. It's very quick.
Yeah.
And it's been a bit controversial, I think, here.
Yeah.
It was an expensive project, but I think it's very good.
I do.
Very
too.
Useful. Say hello. I think I've remembered to do everything.
Good. this moment.